Hi, my name is Winnie Go, and I've been an artist for over 30 years, but mostly in the beginning, making ceramics. But this time, it's been a great honor for me to do something in a different medium. So doing textiles in Boro is just also one of my loves, because I just love working on textile.
How did you discover Boro?
I discovered Boro because I would say about 6 or 7 years ago, because I like to go to Japan, and there, you know, Boro is really the art of mending in Japan. It's an art form there. And I happened to chance upon a piece that I really liked. I bought one. And I happened to show it to Ling and Maya, who are now participating in this exhibition. And we said, oh my God, we just love this whole concept. We love that tattered Boro that I had shown them. And we said that we would one day do an exhibition. So here we are, several years hence, doing this exhibition together.
How long have you been into this art form?
Well, I've been doing indigo dyeing, which is like some of the parts you see here, where it's the denim dyed into this indigo blue, this beautiful blue. I've been exposed to it actually for the last, I would say, 7 or 8 years. But now is really the time that we finally put it together to do a real show. But every now and then, I would just do Boro for myself.
Mm-hmm. So far, how's the technique different from ceramics or other media that you use?
Well, obviously ceramics, we're talking about using clay. Mm-hmm. And I've been doing that for the last 30 years, which I really love. And most of my exhibitions here in AI are doing ceramics. And now, using textile is just, it's a softer medium, so there's more fluidity and resilience, and it's just so much fun. You're talking about sewing, everything is about a meditative technique of sewing in a very slow style, which I really enjoyed. And over the last 2 years, I think a lot of people might feel like they really didn't have a good time, but in my case, I felt it even inspired me further to do something different, to do something which was more introspective and soul-searching in a way.
How about this collection? Can you tell us some stories behind the...
Okay, well, this collection of 16 works is really based on my own personal experiences in my life, especially over the last 2 to 3 years, where I've gone through some deaths in the family and grieving and dealing with COVID. I think a lot of times we become a little bit more introspective and thinking about what's next in our life or what do we want to do with it. And so if I were to show you some of these, for example, like this, for example, this is one small work which I really, really like so much, because it's called Little Men's. And what it is, it means like little acts of forgiveness. And I think there's no one in the world who doesn't have something that happens to them that entails some kind of forgiveness, either to themselves or towards other people. And I think, and this one is actually, you can see the symbol of the cross in textile. And it's really talking about how every single day we can forgive someone about something small or to ourselves. And I think things moving forward will be so much easier in our life. So that's one work. And of course you can see integrating different layers of Boro or textile, all using the running stitch, which is what, and using sashiko thread. That's why you'll notice this, the thread is a bit thicker than the normal, because I used the sashiko thread, the Japanese thread. And then, like for example here, this is one work where you talk about, it starts with a dream. You can see this is a vendor who also with all old 1930s buttons, celluloid and bakelite, these are all the different things that she's selling. There's the fish, watermelon fruit, so it really imitates her own life and how, no matter how rich or poor you are, you always have a dream. And that's what this is all about. This one, for example, also is a work that I really actually, it's an honor to my dad who had some serious problems with his heart and so had to have multiple surgeries. So you can see all the buttons that I put in place are like valves and wrenches and things like that, or tubes. And even that little dynamite you see over here, that's a button which sometimes when you're so full of emotion, you feel like you're about to explode in your heart, right? So that's a little detail which is actually quite funny or comical. Do you want me to show you more?
Yes.
Okay. Over here is called Hanging by a Thread. A couple of years ago, I went to chef school and actually I encountered a lot of challenges being in the kitchen. And that's me hanging by a thread because every day is always a challenge with the chef, you know. And this is a huge, this represents the chef jacket, which is borrowed. And you can see how the personality of the jacket, meaning your job to be in the kitchen, is bigger than your own person. So you're small there, you don't mean anything in the kitchen. You don't even talk about something happened to your grandmother or whatever, you just do your job. That's why for me, that's symbolic of why this jacket is so much bigger than this person, or than myself. And then this one, for example, is called Blueprint. Because in our life, you know, just like a blueprint of a house, we really have a blueprint of what's gonna happen to us. And only Lord knows really what our blueprint is. And some things are never going to be clear. So that's why if you see this little button here, it's 6 plus 5 is 13, which it's supposed to be 11. Mm-hmm. But you can imagine, nothing is so black and white in life, right?
How about that one at the top?
This one? Okay, this one is Sebastopol. This is actually a place where there are a lot of wildflowers that grow. And that's the place that I stayed in a lot during COVID, where there was also some healing that happened for me. And I went through some kind of grieving also for a family member that passed. So that also, although it doesn't look like there's any Boro there, that is a kind of mending for me, mm-hmm. that time. Mm-hmm. And this one for me, I really love this work. Because when I finished with it, I love all these buttons and all the handiwork I did here, all of them. Everything I do is sewing by hand.
Mm-hmm. How long does it take you to finish, for example?
Oh, a long time, because mm-hmm. what I do is I make the skeletal work, mm-hmm. and then sometimes I'll look at it, I'll make the textile behind it, then I'll cut it. Mm-hmm. I'll look at it again, then I don't like it, I'll change it again, then I'll do something else underneath. It's really very painstaking. That's why actually all of this took 2 years to make. You can imagine, it's really long. And so, for example, for this, this reminded me very much of Pasita Abad, that really famous artist we have who painted the bridge in Singapore. Because she always has things in her hair and things, different handcrafted things in her body, right? She just loves that. But you can see this one is a kimono. That's a little difference. It's an ode to what Boro really, where it originally started. So that's why it has a little detail of what looks like a kimono. So that's just like my ode to them. And yet when you look at it, I felt like, when I was gonna give this title, I said, what did it make me think of? I thought of Pasita Abad. And funny enough, I said, I will title this Pasita. And I looked at the dictionary and it said, Eye of God. So, and the eye of this person is much bigger than the other. So it's like, it makes me think like how very apt it was to have that title. And this one is bird song. Did you know that birds, every morning when they awake, they communicate with each other through singing? So this is also part of how nature healed itself all over the world. So it talks to me about that. It talks to me about this place I went where I was also healed there because nature really heals people. So that for me was a very important thing. These two, actually, they're also with very old indigo works behind that, with different odd shapes, as if they're floating in the sky. And this is called the mystical place, and this is called moonlight. Because it really looks very, feels very ethereal, and so I really wanted the shapes to be sort of ethereal and mystical, and a lot of people have that kind of experience in their life, very spiritual. So I wanted to also do that. And plus, you know, I was kind of inspired by Matisse's cutouts, the last work that he did when he was already in the wheelchair. So I really, the shapes are different, but it was a little bit inspired by him.
So even the frames are repurposed?
Yes, all of them are repurposed. All of them came from this framer, a designer framer, actually an artist framer, who I asked, she showed me first one thing that was something, you know, Winnie, I made this, what do you think of this? I'm like, oh my God, I love this. Just make some for me. I want things handmade. Everything following the philosophy of handmade and repurposing. So she didn't buy new wood. She went to the beach, got things on the beach. She went to farms, got broken up fences that were just thrown on the floor. She either asked permission from the farmer to pick it up, or she just took whatever would seem to be left there. And she made things like this. Things like that, you can imagine that it's really things that they were throwing. It's a very rough, but I really love it. This has a very natural look to it. And I think that really made the works come out even more. So I really love it, yeah.
Do you think recycling and borrow will be the future of art, or is it a new trend now in art?
I think everywhere in the world, every culture does some kind of form of borrow, to be honest. And I think young people today are very sensitive to recycling. Young people today, the Z generation, is it? The Z generation? Really understand their priorities maybe a little more, I'm not sure, but that's my impression. And so I think when you go to vintage shops today, you go to secondhand shops, a lot of people who like shopping in those places. I'm also a fan of that because you find treasures there that you would never anymore see today because they've been made 30 years ago. So nobody makes that anymore. Then you discover this thing and you go, oh my God, this is precious. I believe in recycling. I believe in repurposing. I'm sure a lot of young people or people my age do believe in it too.
But since Boro is made of recycled stuff, are they undervalued by, I mean, the art world also?
Well, you know, I'm hoping not. Well, this is, I think, the first time we've ever had a Boro show in this gallery. And maybe other galleries in the Philippines. I'm not sure. Maybe they've never even done Boro. But, you know, I am hopeful that when people buy art, they see more than just the name of the person, but they see what's behind the sentiment. They see what's the reason why people do art. And I think if you do things with your heart, with your passion, with reasons that really make sense, with experiences, lifetime experiences, and deep meanings behind it, I think it makes the art, and if it speaks to you, it makes that piece of art more meaningful, right? There are many artworks out there that may have been done by very famous people, but when you look at it, you might say, well, what does this really mean to me? Nothing really. So I think it depends on each person. Some collectors think differently, but I'm hoping that people will look at the art and look at it for what the substance behind it.
How about as clothing?
I made this.
Yes, I know.
I made this, and I think wearable art is amazing. So I just like making things that are different. I like wearing things that are different, that speaks to your own character. So I'm thinking of making these, I think, for Afro, maybe before the end of the year.
What's Afro,
Mom? Afro is the art gallery, which is a store of made with artists from Afro that make things there, one-of-a-kind things. So it's a very interesting place. Maybe later you can go pass by there. It's amazing.
Sure. Is it here?
It's just down outside and turn right around the corner. Maybe Tina can show it to you. It's amazing. And I think it's nice to make one-of-a-kind pieces, something when you wear, you know, nobody else will have it because it's made by an artist. Yeah.
So and how long have you been making this?
Oh, I've been also making this for couple of years now, but only now that I actually have been really seriously making more and more of it. But it's, you can see, it's all running stitches, indigo dyed, and you know, using all sashiko. And you see how something like this, something somebody might throw away, I keep more because it's like broken up, you know, that's like a patina and something broken up, which actually is very hard to replicate. It's only age, wear and tear that does things like that in the natural way. So I really enjoy doing it, and it's just so fun, and I just love it.
And so far, have you sold many pieces?
No, I'm actually going to be selling it in Afro.
Not yet.
No, not yet. There's a plan.
For now,
it's just for me, for friends. Yeah.
So your friends order, and then you make by just.
Something like that. Actually, yeah. few people who are artists mostly, the ones who love this, I think mostly are a lot of more art or creative people who seem to like this sort of thing.
So far, what other pieces have you made? Only shawls for now?
Yeah, for now, just shawls. Mm-hmm. We'll try to
become an accidental designer also.
Let's see. But I'm just enjoying myself doing different things. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what's your message to people? I mean, how would you encourage them to support Boro art more and recycling also?
Well, I think if people could actually find things which they love, textiles, you know, they can start making their own Boro, right? And they can start doing Boro, not only textile, but different other things, found objects, right? Doing mixed media, whatever it is that they want, whatever speaks to them, because art is about making something that speaks to you, which makes sense for you, and more than anything, something that touches your heart, right? And something which comes from your own personal, deep experience. That's it.
Thank you very much. Yeah.